Welcome back. Well, she is the actress, Australian actress, who made her mark on our screens for decades. But whatever happened to Peta Toppano? From battling crippling depression and a tumultuous private life, she broke her silence for the very first time as she sat down with our very own Craig Bennett.
Peta Toppano has been a mainstay on Australian stages and screens, an actress with the finest credentials, appearing in some of our most beloved shows.
Peta Toppano, I just love you. You are one of the most talented people in the biz. And might I say, speaking of the biz, you've been there since you're a tot, haven't you?
Born into it, literally. Yes.
Well, your mum and dad were famous around the world, Enzo and Peg.
Yeah, they were very, very talented classical musicians. Mum and Dad and Ray Taylor had one of the first morning shows on Channel 7.
Peta tells the amazing story of her birth when her dad Enzo had to hitch a lift with the great Harry Secombe to the hospital, and he made it, but just in the nick of time.
Harry delivered Dad to the door and came rushing in, and so it was, all the nurses were fainting. Here's Harry Secombe and here's my dad, and there was Mum, and out I came. And soon
they'll all know my name. From that moment, she was thrust into the razzle-dazzle of the showbiz spotlight.
It never really occurred to me that people didn't dance, sing, act.
Showbiz is the only world you've known.
I did not know any other world. I won a scholarship to France when I was 16 from the Australian Academy of Ballet, and I spent almost a year over there. I fell down a flight of stairs and injured myself very badly. Had I not fallen down the stairs and hurt myself, I would be in Europe in a ballet company. He used to give
me roses. You became an absolute fan favourite as Karen Travers on Prisoner. Do you have fond memories of your... Because you're one of the original cast members.
I was day one, yeah.
Did you love that show?
I did love it.
It wasn't long after seeing the first script for Prisoner that Peta realised something.
I read it and I thought, this is pretty special. I've never seen women do these sorts of things, like slam each other's heads into ironing presses and, you know, get bashed into cupboards and have fist fights in vegetable gardens. And I don't know whether the viewers know this, but we weren't allowed to wear any makeup at all.
On the set, she formed a close friendship with fellow cast member Carol Burns, who played Frankie.
She was probably the closest friend I had.
And she brought the best out in Peta.
Off camera. Come on, you can do better than that. Come on, give me more. Give it to me, Karen. Come on.
It's up to you, love. You can really enjoy yourself if you put your mind to it.
You should have been in Hollywood. I'm wondering, did Hollywood ever come a-calling?
Harry Secombe's manager put me in touch with some of the biggest agents in Hollywood, and they were going, yeah, you're very pretty, we could do something with you. But back in those days, you're very pretty didn't mean necessarily that you could act. And I got some screen tests, but, you know.
But Peta had it all going for her right here in Australia. You became a sensation in the 80s playing probably one of television's best bitches.
Ha!
It's true. Jilly in The Return to Eden. I loved it.
Jilly.
What is it about playing bitches that is so irresistible?
Oh, you get to say some really, really awesome lines.
The same frigid froth is still right there beneath the plastic surgery and expensive clothes.
Peta has been married three times, her last to business tycoon Kerry Stokes, and she remembers how they met.
I was on stage doing this thing called Stars by Design. Paula Duncan was in it. Lots of girls in big shows, and in the audience was Kerry Stokes. And then it was years later that Les Mis went to Perth and we opened at His Majesty's. I kept receiving exotic presents and invitations to extraordinary places. He was extremely handsome in a wonderful kind of Aussie larrikin sort of way. He was a person I liked a lot.
Peta wanted to dispel some nasty rumours after reading an authorised biography written about her ex-husband, Kerry.
There was something that along the lines that said Peta's career had stalled and that Kerry had come into my career and all of a sudden it had taken off, which actually wasn't true. I also read that I was an alcoholic and some of the things.
Right, so are you an alcoholic?
No, I'm not an alcoholic. I I've had bursts of bad behaviour.
So why didn't it work, do you think?
Distance, and he was very busy with Channel 7 at the time. I was travelling a lot. We did love each other very much, I do believe that.
What a lot of people don't know about you is that you, for many years, suffered absolutely crushing depression.
It's like you're in a box and walls are crushing in on your head. You can't get up, you can't get out of bed, everything hurts too much. During the night, you can't sleep. So you have to go to the cupboard and take out whatever medication it happens to be that helps you to get maybe 2 or 3 hours. It's very hard to hold conversations with people. It's very hard to be just the authentic you. I always felt like I was being somebody else. Depression had a lot to do with the fact that I didn't work for a very long time. Possibly I was considered unreliable.
So you blamed yourself?
I did. I did. And I've been told by many, many doctors and therapists, it's not your fault. It's like that scene in Good Will Hunting. It's not your fault.
But it's not your fault. Hard to reconcile that, though, isn't it, when you're in a black hole?
I will never let depression define my life. Oh, I would love to do some more telly. Studio 10, for example.
Now, it's funny you should mention that, because we'd love you to come on as a fifth panellist.
Would you?
You betcha bippy we would.
That would be so exciting.
Everyone loves you.
I watch it every day.
The phone calls and they say, right, we're doing Jilly again. Would you return to those roles?
I would return to the McElroys in a heartbeat.
And you've still got loads to give.
Thank you, Tom.
Peta, we'd love to play. But I really liked that she said that she wasn't going to be defined by her depression.
I like that very, very much. She's not depressive. She's someone who's had depression and she's fighting it every inch of the way. Mm-hmm. That's great.